Hello. In the previous video, I showed you how to connect your router and how to change the Wi-Fi name. In most cases, one Wi-Fi router is enough to cover your house or your flat with a wireless zone, but not always. For example, it can happen that Wi-Fi signal cannot penetrate into all the rooms, because it gets reflected or absorbed. There are materials like concrete, metal, or water that do have a heavy impact on the Wi-Fi. And so if the signal in your bathroom is poor, do not blame the router, but understand that it could be because of the environment. In this video, we'll mention a couple of things that you can try doing to increase your Wi-Fi coverage without using additional equipment. First tip, we highly suggest avoiding the installation of Wi-Fi routers near aquariums, metal doors, or concrete walls. Try placing them in central locations, taking into account the surrounding material, not behind your TV. Secondly, remember the difference between used Wi-Fi frequencies. 2.4 GHz coverage zone is wider compared to 5 GHz. With 2.4 GHz, you sacrifice overall throughput for a bigger distance. As such, for some users, the solution could be to use an SSID, or in other words, a network name, that is configured in the Wi-Fi interface that represents 2.4 GHz settings. Using 2.4 GHz is the answer, but not for everyone. There could be scenarios where 5 GHz distance is also important. Remember, I've mentioned that there is a country setting that is responsible for which Wi-Fi channel with which output power are allowed to be used in your location. Output power has a direct impact on how strong the Wi-Fi signal is. As you can already guess, per those regulations, there can be channels with low allowed output powers, and there can be channels that are blasting. From the get-go, the frequency channel is configured to be selected automatically, and so additional algorithms run in the background that choose the Wi-Fi channel for you. Unfortunately, it can happen that sometimes not the strongest output power Wi-Fi channel is selected. Here's how you can find out whether it is the case. Connect to the settings, click on the new terminal button in the WinBox, and input the command shown on the screen. But instead of Latvia, input your country. The command will show you frequency ranges and their allowed powers. Based on this, we can conclude that we are able to get the best coverage using channels from the 30 dBm range. Just note that so-called DFS channels could randomly be switched off, as they are also used for radars. When one such radar is detected, your Wi-Fi router can no longer use it for some time, and the channel gets changed. Also remember, when you first enable the interface or on boot up, it will start scanning for radars, and it will make 5 GHz network unavailable for a brief moment. So, you got poor 5 GHz zone. Check your currently used channels by double-clicking on the Wi-Fi interface and navigating to the Status tab. Do you see that the channel from the 14 dBm range is being used? No wonder. If you want to increase the Wi-Fi range, consider manually selecting higher dBm channels in the Channel tab in the Frequency field, as shown. And lastly, if your Wi-Fi is crowded, try setting channel width to 20 MHz. To reduce interference from your neighbors and those ensuring a better and stronger signal. You've tried it all. The physics laws limit your Wi-Fi coverage zone still. What do you do? Add more access points. More on that in the next video. Thank you for watching.